This is the solution video for Unit 8 review, problem number 9. The base of a solid is the region in the xy plane enclosed by y equals 1 over x, y equals negative 1 over x, x equals 1, x equals 4. Set up an integral for the volume of the solid of each plane section of the solid perpendicular to the x-axis is a square, a rectangle, a quarter circle. All right, so first of all, we need to draw a picture. All right, so 1 over x, remember, is the hyperbola that looks like this, right? Negative 1 over x would just be this graph flipped over the x-axis, right? So we've got that. All right, then x equals 1, vertical line. X equals 4, vertical line, right? So we are looking at this region right here, all right, in the first and fourth quadrants. All right, so now, first of all, okay, we are going to be perpendicular to the x-axis, right? So we're going to be using a dx. All right, so for the first one, right, we've got the square coming out of the page at us, right? So really, the height of the dx is just the side of the square. So what would the height of the dx be? Well, it'd be the upper boundary, which is 1 over x, minus the lower boundary, which is negative 1 over x, right? So that's really just 1 over x plus 1 over x, which is 2 over x, right? And so the area of a square is going to be the length of the side, 2 over x, squared, right? And so we're going to integrate the area of the square, which would really just be 4 over x squared, right? Or you could just write 2 over x squared, or you could say 4x to the negative second, right? And then we're going to integrate from left to right, very simple, from 1 to 4, right? Now, this one is a setup only, right? So that is our answer, integral from 1 to 4 of 2 over x quantity squared. All right, next, a rectangle with the length 3 times the width in the xy plane. So now we have the width in the xy plane, right? And the length is 3 times that, right? So now, remember the area of a rectangle, right, is just the, you know, kind of the length times the width. So length times the width. Now the width is the height of the dx. So that would be the 2 over x, right? And so that means the length is 3 times that. So 3 times 2 over x. And so we're going to integrate from 1 to 4 the length times the width. So that would be 6 over x times 2 over x, right? And then with respect to x, right? So that is the setup for B, all right? Setup for C. Now, quarter circle. So remember, the quarter circle is coming out of the page at you, right? So we've got a right angle here. So remember, the height of the dx is going to represent the radius of the quarter circle, right? And so the radius is going to be the 2 over x, right? And so remember, the area of a quarter circle is 1/4 pi times the radius squared, right? And the radius is 2 over x. And so we're going to integrate that. So 1/4 pi times 2 over x squared, and then with respect to x. All right. And so we're going to integrate from 1 to 4. All right. And so we've got the setup for each of those. And that is it for problem number 9.